special job here at the zoo. I get to work with these amazing animals every single day. Believe it or not, we actually get to play together. Playtime is a very important part of our daily routine. Working with dolphins, playtime allows us to do a lot of different things. It allows us to strengthen the bonds that we share. It also allows us to learn brand new behaviors and practice important life skills. Let's be honest, playtime is a whole lot of fun. So of course, that makes us all very happy.
Between them while discovering something very special about each other.
Hello again, everyone. My name is Trent, and like many of you, I actually grew up right here in Indianapolis. Now, growing up, I always dreamed that maybe one day I'd get my very own corner office with a view. But I never realized that my view would end up being quite this good. But my journey started many years ago at 14 years old in this very dolphin pavilion. My very first job was here at the Indianapolis Zoo, but back then, my job was a lot different. I started out by just squeegeeing the water after the dolphin presentations. At one point, I had to do a little bit of elephant poop. Truth be told, I never really left. But now I have this added privilege that I get to come to my full-time job every single day had the opportunity to make some very cool memories along the way. A lot of those memories involve a very special female that you guys got to see me work with here just a little bit ago. Her name is Indy. It is very special to me. She was actually born here at the zoo in the year 2001. She's, of course, named after our city. She is the spitting image of her mother, China. China and Indy both have this genetic underbite, so their lower jaw sticks out just a little bit further than her upper jaw. Now, Indy is a very spunky individual that loves to play and loves to learn. I'd love to introduce her to someone new today. So I actually have Mel from our audience who's actually going to come up here and help me do that. How are you today? I heard you were just visiting today from Fort Wayne. How was the drive?
Long.
Yeah, that's going to be well worth it. Come up here and join me. So you and I are going to meet my friend Indy. Now, Indy is actually a lot like you and I. She has more in common with us than she does with the fish that she eats. Now, as a mammal, it means we have some characteristics that we share. Now, one is that we all have hair. Do you see any hair on her?
Nope.
All dolphins have hair when they're first born, but I can tell you from experience that not all mammals that get hair can keep it. And Indy is the same. All dolphins, boys and girls, are born with a small mustache of hair right along this mouth. We call it a rostrum. And after a few days, it falls out and they never have hair again. Now, also as a mammal, that means they give live birth. So when they're all born, just like us, they have a belly button. That means we're connected to their mom by an umbilical cord. So she's the belly button in the center of her stomach. Would you like to see it? All right. Wait right here. Let me set my bucket down. Now, one really cool thing is so far, with dolphins, we've only seen innies. We haven't seen any outies just yet. Now, she can be a little shy, but let's see how she does with you today. Very calm. Do you want to come up a little bit closer? You want to reach down and just give a nice little rub right there? How does she feel? Very smooth. Good job. All right, I'm going to pull her back up. She's done very good. Let's give her a nice round of applause. She likes applause. You want to come over here with me? She likes toys, but her favorite thing, she likes fish. Would you like to feed her? You just have to pick one of those fish out, and you just can toss it straight into her mouth. She doesn't chew it. She just grabs it, swallows it whole. You want to give her one more? Now I'm going to teach you my favorite trainer trick of all. Now you take that hand, you just go like this, and it's gone. All right, before you leave, we'll give you your own perk today. So what I want you to do is stand right here in front of me. I want you to turn around and face your adoring fans out there. We'll have Indy come up. Do you want to put your hand on her back with me? There you go. And turn, and let's hear it, everybody. Isabel and Indy today. Good job. I'm going to have you head straight out here for Felicia. She's got something for you. So they got to make a brand new connection today, but you all have a connection to dolphins all around the world. So I'd actually like to take you guys on a brief journey to the Gulf of Mexico to find out just a little bit more.
My name is Harris Jeremy. I'm a commercial fisherman. Been doing this for 50 plus years. Then I'll blood the fish and shrimp. We've been doing this for a generation, and we're looking forward to keep doing it. Dolphins are really a part of life down here in Florida. When I'm shrimping and I see schools of dolphins, it's exciting because there's life there.
I'm Ray McCormick, and I'm from Vincennes, Indiana. Everything I do on the farm has an impact on the environment. Every stream on my farm, every river connects up. The Wabash connects with the Ohio, that connects with the Mississippi, that connects with the Gulf. We're all interlinked. And when soil comes into this river, it carries a lot of nutrients with it. That water and the quality of that water impacts the dolphins in the Gulf.
And it's creating a dead zone because it's getting bigger and bigger. And it's a serious problem. We used to catch thousands of pounds a day here, and we don't see that anymore. Not good for the dolphins. The dolphins won't stay in it. And eventually, if it gets too big, then where are the dolphins going to go?
As a landowner and a farmer and a conservationist, I care about all living things. And I understand the relationship between what I do and what impact it has on the Gulf. So I have a great feeling of responsibility to take care of my water and my nutrients, building a healthy soil so that when it rains and we get these hard mountain rains, then most of that water goes right down into the soil where it belongs. What you buy and put on your lawn, where the water goes off your driveway, what happens to the water off of your roof, what happens to the water at the golf course, at the park, at the ball diamond, every drop counts. To keep our soils in place, keep the water on the landscape, that's what's gonna help these dolphins in the Gulf.
We take care of Mother Nature to take care of us. We need to do what's right.
Like a flowing river driven by each drop of water. Together we have the power to make a difference. Each day gives us a new moment to appreciate the wonder of life and a chance to enhance the future of the world we share.
This is the moment we have dreamed of our lives. Be the change we wish from us. We'll stand tall.
Joining us today, but more so, we want to thank you all for helping us to advance our efforts in saving wild things and wild places. Goodbye, everyone.